Now, I do understand one point. People always tell me, okay, dude, you seem to care a lot about animals, you're speaking so much about them. But I care about my health. You speak about the health of the animals, okay. But if I don't eat animal products, what about me? Don't I need them to survive? Now, I think that is a fair and valid question to ask. So I'm going to now talk to you guys. See, when I say meat and eggs, you'll say protein. If I say milk, you'll say calcium. So protein without, first of all, what is protein? Protein is a compound made up of various different amino acids. There are two types of amino acids, essential amino acids and non-essential amino acids. Essential amino acids are what your body will fabricate by itself, and non-essential amino acids are those that you need from an outside force, that is food. Now, there are totally 11 essential and sorry, there are totally 9 essential and 2 conditionally essential amino acids, and they are cysteine, histidine, isoleucine, leucine, lysine, methionine, phenylalanine, threonine, tryptophan, tyrosine, and valine. All of these essential amino acids are found in plant foods. We humans do not need to consume animal foods to get protein. Next slide. Now, I just wanted to show you guys a few examples of this. This is obviously not all. Understand one more thing. When we say protein, there's been enough marketing done to make us think that protein is found only in meat, dairy, and eggs. But you have to understand that all plant foods, every single edible plant on the planet contains protein, but just in varying degrees. Also, the amount of amino acids you find in these plants also differs in varying degrees, that's all. If you look at white rice, this is all per 200 grams. 200 grams of white rice gives us 5.5 grams of protein. That is ragi millet, 14.5 grams of protein. Wheat, 26.5, that is amaranth. Then we have here soybeans, tofu, soy chunks, urad dal, channa. We have here tuar dal. The point is that if you eat a diet that is sourced only from plants, and you include food from two groups, that is grains. Grains means like your rice, wheat, oats, and your millets. And also you include food from the other group known as the legume family. In India, we call them as dals. For example, what is idli? It is rice with urad dal. What is sambar rice? It's again rice with tuar dal. Rajma chawal literally means rajma and rice. Poha is flattened rice with peanuts. As long as you include foods from the legume family and from the grain family, you will get all the amino acids that your body needs. The human body does not need to consume meat or eggs in order to get protein. I just want to dispel that myth. This is also a pet peeve that I have, and I wanted to get it off my chest. This happened, by the way, in a lecture 3.5 years ago. I was giving a lecture in Bangalore, and a student during Q&A, he stood up and told me, listen, man, I don't want to be a vegan for one simple reason. First of all, don't take it in the wrong way. You are so skinny. You're standing there on stage. If I become a vegan, I look like you. I want to eat a lot of protein. I want to be a real man. I want to get muscular, and real men eat meat. Okay. So here's the problem I have with that statement. This is this modern day absurd thinking about the human body. What has happened is basically this. Up, you have bodybuilders there. Bodybuilders are extremely disciplined, extremely hardworking. They diet properly and they work out like crazy. So I'll give them credit for all of those four things. Okay, but you are aware that bodybuilders use a substance known as steroids, right? They use anabolic steroids. They inject artificial testosterone into their body through a needle. They also take growth hormones. Naturally, a human being, I will challenge anyone here, whether you're vegan, eat whatever you want, you can train for a million years, you will never look like the ones on top. Ever. You can't even dream to look like them. You know why? Because they are not natural human beings. Your body can only produce so much testosterone. Your body can only do so much. Now the problem here is this. The meat industry, the egg industry, and the dairy industry have capitalized on the pictures on top. They now come out and promote their products by saying, real men eat meat. You want to get big muscles? Buy my whey protein supplements. But the problem is they don't actually show you real human beings. They don't show you natural human beings. They show you human beings who have been enhancing themselves through steroids and growth hormones making us feel insecure about how we look. Oh my God, look at me, I'm so skinny. So maybe if I take these supplements and eat so much meat, I'll look like them. No. If you eat too much meat, you won't get muscular. You'll only get fatter. More protein does not make you bigger. It's more calories. It just makes you gain weight. So to show in contrast with these things, look at the three groups of people below. They are not vegans. They are hunter-gatherers. If there's anyone who's eating, in fact, this stuff also keeps coming up. Heard of this ketogenic diet, paleo diet, that's being really popularized right now. They say they keep eating more meat, eat like our ancestors ate. Our ancestors were big and strong because they hunted and ate meat. Not true, because this is what our ancestors looked like, the photos on the bottom. This is from Papua New Guinea. It's a tribe living over there. They subsist mainly on sweet potatoes, sweet potato leaves, and of course, they're also hunters. They hunt and kill animals. They've been living like that for generations. And look at their physique. Does it look big and muscular like these people on top? Or do they look like normal human beings? Next, you have the Maasai tribe from Kenya in Africa. These people are known to be excellent runners. They literally drink raw blood from the animal. They eat so much meat. But look at their physique. If really meat was supposed to make you big and muscular, why don't they look like that? The last picture, I think, is taken from a South American, I'm not sure, too sure where I took that from South American tribe, I guess. So the point I want to make is this. The meat, dairy, and egg industries have been deceptively marketing to us. They are trying to make us feel, especially men, feel insecure about our physiques and say that real men eat meat, and if you don't eat meat, you'll never look like this. I want to reiterate, you can never look like the pictures on top unless you take steroids. Now listen, your body, your choice. If you want to go and take steroids and growth hormones, more power to you, do what you want to do. But please do not look at these people and think that is why you need to eat meat. That doesn't make any sense. The humans below are normal human beings who do live in the wild, who do live like how our ancestors lived in paleo times, yet they look like this. This is reality. I just wanted to put that forth to you guys.